Hello guys, and welcome back to another Wicked Wednesday. Before I get started, I will put when the actual story talking begins right here for those of you who just want to skip right ahead. But first off, I want to say thank you to every single one of you who has subscribed to my channel and who comment or like or whatever you guys are doing to communicate with me. I love it. I wish I could do this full time. I genuinely love doing this. It's so much fun. And I want to apologize that the last 2 weeks you guys haven't had a Wicked Wednesday video come up. To be honest with you, it's because these videos are a lot harder to produce and put forward than beauty unboxings or lifestyle videos. Because I can unbox something on camera and just do a quick edit and upload it, and that's really easy. But these videos, I love the content, and I really want to make sure that what I'm putting out for you guys is genuine and something that I am proud of, and not just a let's unbox some BoxyCharm and call it a day. As much as I love makeup, I know some of you guys are here strictly for Wicked Wednesdays, and I really appreciate your subscription because I know maybe makeup and the other videos I put out aren't your thing, but these are, so I don't want to let you guys down. So thank you for subscribing and staying subscribed. Leave comments down below. Let me know what you guys want to see. I do have a subscriber recommended story coming up either next week or the following week. I haven't decided yet, but it is the Mogollon Monster, and I believe, who was it? I think it was Fish Forever is their username. Let me look it up. Fish Forever recommended that. So I do take your recommendations seriously. I want to put out stuff that you guys want to see, and it helps me broaden my horizons as far as what's going on in the world. It doesn't have to be in North America. It can really be anywhere. I just tend to concentrate on North America because that's places that I can relate to. But yeah, enough of my babbling. Thank you guys for being here. Thank you for appreciating my Wicked Wednesday videos. Okay, let's get started. So the Fresno Nightcrawlers, or Nightwalkers, depending on who you ask, are probably among one of the most interesting creatures I have researched so far. And the only reason being is because they've done absolutely nothing wrong. When you have creatures like Bigfoot or Dogman who wreak havoc upon communities, steal animals, scare people, possibly be the reason people go missing in state parks or just in places. That does kind of instill a little bit of fear in you, but the Fresno Nightcrawlers, no matter how scary their name is, have only been spotted. Nobody has reported them doing anything wrong in Fresno or in the surrounding areas of where they are seen. So I find that incredibly interesting. But the story itself is said to come from Native American lore in that area. Now, the sightings of them had kind of gone quiet for quite some time. Like I said, they were an old lore that was spoken about. And then in 1990, suddenly this video popped up of a man recording them in his front yard. Actually, I think it was two of them. If I can insert videos, I will, if I can figure that out, of them just walking across his lawn. It's quite bizarre. The whole thing's weird. If I can't get the video in here, I will link it down below so you guys can form your own opinions about it. But they're really just walking. They're not doing anything wrong. People don't report to feel fear like they're gonna hurt them. They're just scared because it's a different type of creature that they're not used to. So I'm really curious as to what they are. Why are they here? Are they just creatures that are out in the forest that have been unidentified, or are they kids playing pranks on people? So keep in mind, even though Fresno is out away from a lot of places, it is still a relatively large community. It is a city. So I find it incredibly strange that these types of creatures would venture into the city itself. Now, I don't find it strange to see something weird out in the hills in Yosemite. I find it weird to see something like this in Fresno. So my question, or my concern that I pose to you guys, if you want to leave a comment down below, is how are they going undetected? Do they only come out at night? Where are they hiding? They seem to be quite large, the size of a large man, and could even be as small as a small child. But with that being said, let me get into kind of the build of them and kind of their pack. So they basically look like a pair of pants with a head popped right onto them. Now, the head has no sign of a mouth, eyes, any distinguishable features. It's just a sphere that we consider a head to be popped right on top. We don't know what it does. We don't know what it could potentially do. We can't see its eyes. They are said to be, and in the videos, they show up as white and kind of their pants. I'm gonna call them pants. So their legs are covered in what looks like pants. Is that, and it sways in the breeze. Is that their skin? Is that pants? Are they wearing clothing, or is that their skin that's moving like that? Now, I will refer to their body parts in similar to those of human body parts because I don't know how else to say it, but it looks like their femurs are incredibly long, and then their, I don't know what it would be, their shin bones are quite small. And the way that their legs move appear that their joints don't move front and back like ours do. They have kind of a different gait to them where they can kind of rotate within the socket a little bit, if you will. Again, if I can't get this video in here and you don't know what I'm talking about, watch the videos. I will link them down below if I can't get them into here. Now, as far as their pack goes, they appear to travel in at least twos. I think the max that has been seen is four at once. And there's always a large one or multiple large ones with a potential child or a smaller one with it. Some people have hypothesized that these are families that are traveling, or they are just different sized creatures. Perhaps there's an alpha. Again, we don't really know. This is all just speculation. Are they even real? Now, obviously, like I said, they are bipedal, so they're walking on two legs, and they look really clumsy, in my opinion. They look like something on stilts, but it just doesn't look like a human on stilts. So my question, and something that people have posed, is what do they eat? They don't appear to be aggressive. We can't see their mouths. Do they just not eat? Which I'll get into that. Are they omnivores, herbivores, or carnivores? Are they actually really swift and fast creatures, and this is just them taking a stroll in somebody's front yard or in the forest? Are they able to leap up into trees? Are they able to be incredibly agile and hunt other creatures down? Again, we don't know. So with all of this being said, I know this is kind of a quick video and there's not really a lot on it. That brings us to the main question, is what are they? Are they mythical beings? Are they creatures that have been here since time began? Are they something from a portal to hell? What are they? Some people, and this is one that I found to be incredibly fascinating, say that according to the Native American lore, and again, take this all with speculation, do your own research. People say that the Native American lore call these sky fairies or earth fairies. Again, two separate ways of it being said, that came from the sky. So what do you think about when you hear that? Creatures that came from the sky. Aliens. I think about aliens. So some people believe that these are aliens that are here just simply observing us, that hide away and then come into town, potentially taking our garbage, going through our belongings that we have thrown away to research us, and that these things that they're wearing are their strange mockings or trying to look like us with what they have. And so that's why they look so strange, is because they're trying to emulate humans and our clothing, but they're unable to with the type of stuff that they have because they don't have clothing like we do and they don't have the bodies like we do. So that would mean they look a little bit different. But again, if these are aliens, why are they visiting Fresno? Nothing against Fresno. I was only in it passing through. I went to a Walmart, so I don't really have much to really say about it, but it's not incredibly close to things. Like I said, it is a populated city, but it's pretty far out there. And why not go somewhere like Los Angeles, San Francisco, Sacramento, San Diego? There's a lot of large cities with more people. But some people could say that they went to Fresno because there are these surrounding hills in which they could hide in. But there's also that in LA, San Diego. I've never been to San Francisco or Sacramento, so I can't say it about that. But perhaps the population was just enough for them to get what they need and be able to retreat and hide. What do you guys think? Now, as I mentioned, the video of, or as I've inserted, the video of the creatures going across the front yard has been under a lot of speculation. Some, I guess, research groups have tried to imitate that kind of walk. They've had pulley systems. They've had kids walking funky through the yard. They have had a robot thing, a dummy, I don't know what to call it, try and move across the yard, and they haven't been able to imitate the creature. They have come close, and I have seen other videos where people have come really, really close, but there's just something about the gait of this walk that they, I hope I'm saying that correctly, there's something about the way these creatures walk that just, there's something missing in the people who have gotten close. Now, I firmly believe in mass hysteria, creating something in your brain, going out into the forest and thinking you see it. I mean, it's a thing, it's a psychological thing. So what do you guys think? Are people hearing this story and then going out into these forests and saying they see it? Is it something like that? Now, another thing, before I end this video, I think it's really important to tell you guys that I have found and come across a couple of articles, and I don't know the validity of them, that have stated that there is no true Native American lore in this area about these types of creatures. They're saying that the lore itself doesn't discuss these types of beings or doesn't describe these types of beings in this way. And some people have also said that these statues that you might see circulating around the net, if I can insert one, again, I will, are actually from back east and is just an artist who created them, and they've gotten worked up into this big story. So it's kind of like, don't ostracize me for saying this, but it's similar to the hyping things up of Slender Man. People take these items and relate them back to this story and create something in their heads. Do you think that is happening? Or do you think these are real creatures, whether they be earthborn or whether they be spaceborn? What do you think? Are they real creatures? Are they in our head? Where do they come from? What are they doing? I'm just singing, where did you come from? Where did you go? But how many times am I gonna say? That's about it, you guys. I really hope you enjoyed this video. It's something a little bit difficult for me to research. I found this one to be one of the most difficult for me to kind of get across. This is my fourth time recording this because I just keep getting caught in my words on this one. And it's very strange. Like I said, this is just kind of me now reflecting on the whole story. I have been up in that area. I just simply drove through Fresno, but I did stay the night up in Yosemite. So I do know how kind of desolate it can be out there when you really get up into the hills. And to be honest, I love the forest. I love being out at night. There's just something a little uneasy about that forest at night, in my opinion. I know some people love it, but for me, of all of the forests that I've been in or all of the campsites that I've been to, there was just something that I was a little nervous about. I don't know if I was nervous because there were bears, which I know I was nervous because there were bears, but I feel like there was just something else that was making me nervous. Now, again, I could just be completely overreacting. I do that a lot, but yeah, that is it. Let me know what you guys think down below. Let me know if you guys have any suggestions for any types of videos. Again, I am so sorry the last 2 weeks you haven't had a Wicked Wednesday. I will try to never let that happen again. I just get so busy, and these videos mean so much to me that I really want them to be well put together for you. So yeah, subscribe. And I hope you are having a fantastic time wherever you are, and whatever time it is, I hope you have an amazing day. Okay, stay spooky. Bye.